Hi, I'm Dave Miersch. I am Revelwood's Workday Adaptive Planning Practice Leader, and today I'm going to show you how to utilize a split row and an allocation time span to split individuals between multiple departments within the personnel sheet. Okay, let's dive into it then. So the first thing I want to do is I want to make sure that my columns in my personnel sheet are splittable to the areas I want them to be split by. So to do that, I need to make sure that I go to my settings menu and I have allow splits checked off. If this is not checked off, you're not going to be able to assign your specific columns you want to have splittable. In this case, I have it checked off, so I'm going to hit OK. And I've already gone ahead and done this, but the two areas I want to be able to split by in this situation are levels and allocation percentages. I want to be able to split individual staff members between, let's say, SG&A or operations, depending on a percentage of time, but not have to worry about creating two separate records of one person. So that will be split by level, but also allocation percentage, which in this case is a time span. Now it's a time span because in this situation, I want to be able to allocate individuals, not just across the board for one version, but I want to be able to flex that number up and down on a month-to-month basis. And so if you look at both level, I've checked off that top right-hand corner of split, as well as allocation percentage is also checked off. All my other information within this personnel model are not splittable, meaning in both rows or multiple rows of one record, these will be grayed out and only editable at the top row level. You'll see that in a few seconds here. The next step we have to do is to make sure that our account structure is going to be reflective of this new allocation entry point. And so how we do that is in our account administration. Now, as you may know, most personnel salary calculations, whether it be salary, benefits, payroll taxes, etc., those are based off of the partial headcount and headcount calculations. This accounts to make sure that we're not doing any calculations for salaries when people aren't hired yet or have been terminated or have moved departments. And so we use those accounts as essentially flags to multiply the salary information by a 1 or a 0. In this case, however, we're going to be modifying our formulas in a way that's going to allow us to apply that time span percentage against those individual calculations. And so I have an example here within my partial headcount calculation broken up into three sections. The first piece is a if statement. I'm just going to separate that so you guys can see a little clearer. Is if is blank row.timespan. And what we're gonna use that for is, I don't wanna have every single row have to have 100% entered if they're not being allocated. So by saying if this row is blank, then just do my standard personnel partial headcount calculation, I'm essentially making a blank row equivalent to 100%. And that's just for my benefit, I like doing that because it's gonna make my process easier, less confusing to the end user. They're not gonna have to worry about entering 100% every single row for hundreds of people in some situations. The next situation is if it's not blank, meaning there's anything zero or greater has been entered as a percentage in that time span. And all we're doing here is taking that time span calculation, again on a monthly basis, times my original partial headcount calculation. Okay. Now if we see the personnel salary detail, you'll see that my salary information is actually referencing that headcount model. So I'm not changing any other formulas other than the partial headcount. Again, make my life as easy as possible, make it as dynamic as possible. Okay. So now that I made those changes, let's see how it looks within the actual personnel sheet. I have two examples here of individuals in my company who I want to either split or not split between different departments or levels in this case. I have John Smith, who's in production and sales, and I have Jane Doe, who is in SG&A. One is an hourly employee, one is a salaried employee. That does not matter in this situation. Then I have my time span. I have January 2021 and beyond. This is where I'm going to enter my percentages of allocations. Now, as an example here, before I enter an actual split, I just want to show how this is working within the actual formula I showed you as far as it is blank. So if I click on a row details, I'm just going to drag this over to my 2021 period. And you'll see that even though my allocation percent is zero, my partial headcount and my personnel headcount is still a one. Again, because if it's blank, it's assuming that this is equivalent to 100% and I want to use that in my partial headcount calculation. So now how do I actually allocate individuals? I'm going to allocate Jane Doe because even though she's currently in SG&A, I want to allocate her salary between two different departments. While she spends most of her time in SG&A, she does also spend some time in production and sales. So to do that, I'm going to right click anywhere in her row. I'm going to hit split row. And that creates a drop down. I'm going to do that twice because I actually want to split this individual between two different departments. And so you'll see in these two new rows, all these gray cells, those are only editable, again, at the top row because I did not select them in the back end of being able to be split. So before I go any further, I'm just going to change SG&A for the second row to be production and sales. I'm just going to save that real quick. Now, one thing to note, if I do this and split this individual two ways, this is essentially calculating her twice because there's no allocations. So that's something just to be mindful of and careful of. And so now that I have these allocated, or split, excuse me, I'm going to put my allocation percentages. I'm going to start off with 75% of Jane Doe's time is spent SG&A, and 25% of her time is spent in production and sales. I'm going to, for the time being, assume that that is her allocation for the near future, and it's going to copy that forward to the end of the year. Now I'm going to save that and lock that number in. And so currently Jane Doe, even though she's making $100,000 in two different departments, this is now going to allocate her time with 75% of her salary going to SG&A and 25% of her salary going to production and sales. Everything associated with that, whether it be payroll taxes, benefits, 401k, etc., those are also going to be allocated in the same fashion. So I'm going to row detail this first row, which is her SG&A allocation. And we'll see when I get to January 21, which is where I've started my allocation, if I do a comparison between December 2020 and January 2021, I can see the allocation percent being applied. But also, my partial headcount is now being allocated down to 0.75 of an FTE as well. You'll notice that although the salary has changed because of merit increases between December and January, the actual salary being applied to SG&A drops by roughly 25%. Okay. Now, if we look at what this looks like on the flip side, I would assume that production sales would show the same information, but as opposed to 75%, we're going to see the 25%, which we do. So again, this is 25% of that total salary across all periods. Now, the benefit of doing this in a time span versus a singular column, which I certainly could have done, is that I'm able to flex this number between different periods. Maybe there is a operational change where Jane has to spend more time in production and sales than previously expected. Well, in a different version, I may want to create this same personnel sheet, but starting in April, maybe I want it to be a 50-50 split. And I can change that. And again, copy that forward, assuming that it's going to be a 50-50 split for the remainder of the year, and save that. So this allows me to not only change it by month to month, but also I can now look at my original budget where she was planning at 75% every month, versus my reforecast that she's showing 75% for Q1 and then 50-50% for Q2 and beyond. And just as one quick example again for my row details, now that I've saved this change, when I look at 2021, I will see that starting in April, her partial headcount goes from 75% for SG&A down to 50% for SG&A. And I see that same change reflective in her actual salary, her taxes, PTO accruals, any additional calculations we may have for her pay rate and calculations from that point forward. And there you have it. That is how we allocate staff across personnel models using a split row and a time span for allocation percentages. So thanks for following along. I hope you found this helpful in additional ways of utilizing personnel sheets within adaptive planning. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to us at revelwood.com, and we'd be happy to help you out with any of your additional forecasting and planning needs.